ओके
नमस्कार शुभ सकाल वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी आई देवव्रत भद्र ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी हार्टली वेलकम यू द वन डे स्टेट लेवल वेबिनार एंटाइटल्ड पोस्ट पैंडेमिक टीचिंग लर्निंग मेथड अ पैराडाइम शिफ्ट वेबिनार इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड जॉइंटली बाय द इंटरनल क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस सेल ऑफ भैरव गांगुली कॉलेज इन कोलैबोरेशन विद एक्यूएसी ऑफ श्री चैतन्य कॉलेज हावड़ा वी आर ओवरवेल्मड By the enthusiastic response showed by the participants, we have teachers not only from our state West Bengal, but from other states including Bihar, Rajasthan, Kerala, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Himachal Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Uttarakhand, Gujarat, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, and Assam. The sheer number of participants bears testimony to the relevance of the webinar during this pandemic. We all realize that the post-pandemic scenario is going to be very different from the pre-COVID-19 times. Since work from home is not is the new normal, the webinar is an attempt to understand and grapple with the changes in the methods adopted in the teaching learning process in higher education. We the teachers are more or less aware of the use of ICT, but now it is no longer a matter of choice. Online teaching has become the bridge between teachers and the students under the constraints of the present crisis. When the organizing committee was envisioning the purpose of this webinar, we felt the need for enhancement of online teaching and learning methods with the tools at our disposal. In addition to social networking sites like Facebook and WhatsApp, we are now learning the use of platforms like Zoom, WebEx, Teams, Google Meet as the media for conducting lectures. In this regard, I must mention MHRD initiated a number of projects to assist students and teachers and lifelong learners covering educational requirements ranging from KG to PG. Swayamprabha, National Digital Library, Virtual Labs, E-Gyankosh, Diksha, E-Pathshala, E-Shodshindu, to name a few. NPTEL provides e-learning to online web and video courses in engineering science and humanities and other streams. We look forward to a day full of insightful presentations which will enhance our comprehension of blended learning. With this brief introduction, I now request the IQSC coordinator of Bhairav Ganguly College, Dr. Shyamali Dewan, to deliver her welcome address. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bhadru. Good morning, everybody. I think everyone is in the pink of health. Respected Vice Principal, Dr. S.K. Dash, Bhairav Ganguly College, Dr. Dipendu Panigrahi, Coordinator of IQSC, Sri Chaitanya College, Habra, Dr. S.K. Abul Salam, Librarian, Shibpur, Dinobandhu College, Howrah. Dr. Manoj Boddo, our Honorable Speaker, Malda College, Principal of Malda College. My dear colleagues and my beloved students. On behalf of IQSC, Bhairav Ganguly College, I welcome all of you in the webinar. It is my great pleasure that our college has taken keen initiative to conduct such a webinar when almost all people are panicked with COVID-19 and have locked themselves up at their homes. Fear of COVID-19 is chasing us towards an unknown world which I never seen earlier. To tackle the situation, we shall have to think how to manage and how to overcome it. Under this scenario, mode of thinking and learning and the platform of teaching learning is being shifted from direct teaching to a virtual platform. From this point of view, Vodak Ganguly College, in collaboration with Sri Chaitanya College Habra, has organized the webinar entitled Post-Pandemic Teaching Learning Method, A Paradigm Shift. Purpose of the webinar is to learn how to reach to our students using virtual platform and how to utilize online resources. The process of learning is ever-ending. We have to learn about virtual platform like Google Docs, Google Tools, Zoom platform, Zoom Meet, and so on. Our program is divided into two phases. In phase one, speaker is Dr. Manoj Boddo, principal of Malda College. In phase two, speaker is Dr. Ellen Shatpathy, director, UGC-HRDC, University of Calcutta. They will share their valuable expertise with us. And at the end of the session, a feedback form link will be provided in the YouTube box. Please fill up the feedback form. And participants are requested, please don't send in the message like good morning, good afternoon, etc. Please only send messages which relevant to our webinar. I think participants will be benefited by attending the webinar and they would be able to apply those platforms in their teaching learning processes. Now, I would like to thank our team members of IQVC of Vairav Ganguly College and also team members of IQVC of Sri Chaitanya College, Habra, for their constant support. I am also thankful to our vice principal for his active cooperation. It is my great pleasure to thank Dr. Salam for his technical assistance to give the webinar a successful shape. Now, I request Dr. S.K. Das, our Honorable Vice Principal, to inaugurate the webinar officially. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good morning and welcome to this one-day state-level webinar on post-pandemic teaching learning methods organized jointly by the IQAC Shell of Bhairav Ganguly College and Habra Sri Chaitanya College. First of all, I express my heartiest thanks to Dr. Indra Mohan Mondol, the principal, and Dr. Dibbendu Panigrahi, the IQAC coordinator of Habra Sri Chaitanya College for extending their cooperation. I'm grateful to Dr. Abul Salam, the Shripud Divinamundu College, for his technical support in shaping this webinar in our college. I'm grateful to Dr. Shamuli Dewan, coordinator of IQACCL, and all the members of the IQACCL for their constant efforts and support for organizing this webinar in this critical situation. I express my gratitude to Dr. Manoj Boddo, principal of Vairav Ganguly College, and principal of Malda College, and Professor Lakshmi Narayan Shatpathy, director of UGC-HRDC, University of Calcutta. They are the two resource persons they will share their valuable time and speech for enlightening us with this in this situation. These two gentlemen is for a long time with us, associated with this college in different academic and administrative activities. Vairav Ganguly College is a general degree college located in the North Kolkata metropolis, particularly in Belghoria. Started its journey in 1968, the college has already passed 51 glorious years. In course of time, the college has shaped as per the demand of the students and the locality. At present, the college offers 23 honors courses and 4 PG courses under the affiliation of West Bengal State University. Apart from education, we always promote sports and social activities, and we have an indoor sports complex and a swimming pool is underway with the financial support of University Grants Commission. And under the banner of Unnato Bharat Vision, we are working for the development of the socio-economic well-being of tribal people of five villages in Bankura district. And we have a sound infrastructure facilities in our college, but still we are trying to improve it. And with the financial assistance of 1 crore and 50 lakhs from Drusha, we have introduced a central research lab and many more ICT-enabled facilities. And we have a backup plan for preparing a 120-seater computer lab for the online examination. And now the six words, starting with C and ending with A, have changed the entire socioeconomic pattern of the world. And the higher education is not at all exception. And we have to adapt the changing demand of time in regard to the examination, evaluation, and education system. And you know that the government and the university will take necessary steps, but it is sure that there will be new things coming on in the future. And in this moment or in this background, we the teachers have the responsibility to update ourselves, change our attitude and perception so that we may assist the students, we may help them, and we may create them as per the need of the time. You know that threats and opportunities comes together. There are certain threats, but there is an array of opportunities, and we have to grab these opportunities in course of time. And I hope that the two resource person will enrich you to solve the problems we are facing and help to prepare yourself for a better tomorrow. And stay home, stay safe, and enjoy the session. I formally inaugurate the session, and I request Dr. Dibyendu Panigrahi, the coordinator of IQSCCL of Habra Sri Chaitanya College, for his welcome address. Thank you.
A great pleasure that IQSC of Ganguly College and IQSC of Sri Chaitanya College Habra have arranged a level webinar, the topic post-pandemic teaching learning method, a paradigm shift. It's my privilege to have been asked to produce a session. I'd like to express my heartfelt gratitude to honorable speakers, Dr. Manoj Boydo, Principal Malda College, Professor Ellen Satpathy, Director, UGC HRDC, University of Calcutta. I may like to express our sincere thanks to respected Dr. Indrajul, Principal, Sri Chaitanya College, Habra, as Vice Principal, Bhairav Ganguly College, for providing us continuous encouragement. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to Dr. Shyamoli Dewan, Coordinator, IQSC, Bhairav Ganguly College, and Dr. Debok of Bhairav Ganguly College, Organizing Secretary of this webinar, for their continuous effort which made this event possible. I extend my big thanks to the IQSC members and colleagues of both colleges for their support. An event like this cannot happen without a team of very motivated and dedicated. I, on behalf of the organizing committee of this webinar, give special thanks to the entire technical team. We are also grateful to Dr. Abul Salam, librarian, Shippur Dinobondhu Institution College, Howrah, for his technical guidance to manage such a huge number of participants in a single window. Finally, I would like to thank our most valued participants who have turned up in such a great number. Otherwise, this webinar could not have been possible. And I hope everybody enjoy. Thank you.
So we came to the end of the inauguration ceremony now. So in the first session, we have with us Dr. Manoj Kumar Boidu, who himself needs no introduction. From the personal note, I have learned to create Google Forms and uses of Docs, Gibbs, Jamboard, and other add-on applications from him. When seminars were not transformed into webinars, he acted as resource persons twice in our college in face-to-face mode. Perhaps he is the he is one of the few principals in West Bengal who have a dedicated site on online classes of his expertise. And the tagline of his online class is "Learn together, grow together." Besides his academic records, he is a very dynamic person, enthusiastic about his personal and administrative discourse. He has successfully conducted ICT workshop on hands-on training basis as a key resource person in more than 40 colleges all over the West Bengal. He has developed various application softwares using mainly Google Sheets in academic and administrative practice on education. Before that, he served Malda College as an associate professor in the Department of Commerce. He obtained his MCOM degree from University of Calcutta, and he was awarded with the Certificate of Excellence by Goenka College of Commerce and Business Administration, National Scholarship Performance of BCOM Examinations. He has also obtained BA degree from University of Calcutta, intermediate examination held by ICAI. Previously, Dr. Boidu served as a lecturer in the management under WBUT. He possesses teaching experiences of 19 years at undergraduate level. His present area of research is efficiency evaluation of Indian banks using popular methodology, data development analysis. He has contributed various research papers in renowned peer-reviewed national and international journals. He has presented research papers in various conferences. He has authored one book, namely Efficient Banking in Indian Banking Industry, published by reputed publications of New Delhi. He has also entitled a book and completed a minor projects and various projects. So now he has served for the couple of years as principal of Malda College. He was previously the coordinator of IQAC. And with this short introduction, I now request Dr. Manoj Boidu to deliver his lecture. Before he joins, I just request participants, if you want to learn from him, you have to turn on your laptops so that what he can do, you can easily practice it by your own laptop. Because you are on web, so your mobile is being pre-engaged. Therefore, I request whoever is interested, please turn off your laptops while Dr. Boidu is speaking. So the dais is yours, sir.
Thank you. Am I audible?
Sure.
Yes, sir.
One minute, just I would like to share my screen. Is it visible?
Yes,
hello.
Sir.
Okay. So before going to start my lecture, first of all, I convey my sincere thanks to the organizers of Bhairav Ganguly College, especially Dr. S.K. Das, Vice Principal, Dr. Deboboto Bhadro, my brother, dynamic, like-minded, energetic teacher of this college, and the entire team of the Bhairav Ganguly College for giving me this opportunity to share my little bit expertise in the field of how to use ICT in teaching learning practices. I also like to convey my sincere thanks to all LearnNet participants. Basically, I am closely associated with Bhairav Ganguly College since 2017. Probably today's lecture is 3rd or 4th lecture. But this lecture I am delivering sitting my home at Malda, 400 kilometers away from Kolkata. So Corona, COVID-19, is not only creates a disaster, I think it also gives a opportunity to come together, to learn together. So with saying this, now I am going to my main part of the today's webinar. Basically, I have divided my lecture in 3 parts. First part, I will talk upon the use of Google Apps and online evolution. Probably this part will be covered within 1 hour. And after that, I will take 15 minutes how we can apply these Google Apps both in the teaching and administrative purpose. And finally, I would like to share my opinion regarding the online class, regarding the future of online class, regarding the change of shape of education in near future. So today's lecture have been covered by these 3 parts. So let's start the first part. Always I will start my lecture by saying this very important statement as given by Sundar Pichai. The technology alone will not improve education, but it can be a powerful part of the solution. Remember this part. And we know the technology is now changing the shape of education. Technology is transforming teaching and learning. It helps the students at their own pace become creative problem solvers and effective collaborators. So with this saying, I will recommend, there are so many free Google apps that are teaching tools. I am recommending 9 apps, 9 tools, Google tools, as already mentioned my slide. I suggest if teachers will follow these 9 apps in a combination, the teaching methods will be more ICT friendly, students will get more interest, at the same time teachers can avoid repetitive work, at the same time the teaching methods will be more responsible, I think effective. So next part, very important and interesting probably. Now we are becoming a digital teacher. You know, during this COVID-19, during the pandemic, all the teachers, probably majority teachers, are using the internet platform for touching with the students. But if we follow these Google apps, that as I mentioned, the 9 apps, 9 tools, the teaching methods will be more interesting and more attractive. Students will get benefit as well as teachers. So first of all, I will just mention the 9 apps in a very repeating manner, in a very short way. First of all, you all know the Google Drive. It is a 15 GB cloud space where we can save our files and share our files. Even we can transfer our ownership of file. So this is a cloud space. We all know this about the Google Drive. But another thing, Google Docs, Google Sheet, and Google Slide. These are the office documents by which almost same thing like a Microsoft Excel, Word, and PowerPoint. File sharing in a viewer mode, in a commentator mode, or even editor mode. We can share our files. Third point, voice typing in many languages is possible. Collaborative work, the major advantages of Google Docs and Sheet, it is in a collaborative work we can perform our duty. Revision history of collaborative work is possible. we can publish the Google Docs, Google Sheet, or Google Slide in a web page very easily and user-friendly way. Embedded the file in our website. File protection is possible. Transfer ownership of files is possible. So these are the very unique advantages of Google Sheets and etc. So I request the teachers, please follow this Google Sheet, Google Slide, and Google Docs in a various way. You can perform your duty just like a Excel, PowerPoint. It is rather more advantageous as it is a collaborative. And Google Form, yes. Actually, the Google Form might change my world, change my perspective, change my teaching methods also. So by Google Form, we can collect the data, various data. Responses can be viewed immediately with the option to save in Google Sheet. And finally, we can apply Google Form in various purposes. We can apply Google Form for online attendance of the students, for getting feedback of the students, and many more. And Google Classroom, now it is becoming more popular. One thing I request, please avoid the WhatsApp group. I request the teachers, please follow the Google Classroom, as Google Classroom provides the archive in a very systematic date and time basis. So in our next preparation, it will be more helpful. So what Google Classroom do? Exposure to online learning, easy sharing and access of e-material. Evaluation and gradation is possible through Google Classroom. Classroom creation is a matter of 2 minutes, but creation of Google WhatsApp group is really takes major time. No need to save any mobile number or etc. If we create a Google Classroom, and we can create a group within 2 minutes. Student can access all e-materials at any time, even if he or she does not have a laptop or a smartphone. Even if after 1 or more years being included in the classroom. This is the major advantages of Google Classroom. More student engagement, 24/7 hours. Systematic digital archive is possible. So this is a Google Classroom and Google Sites. By these apps, by these add-ons, we can create our personal website, even departmental websites. So this is very user friendly. Just I will point it out. If anyone take interest, I suggest he may contact with me. One thing, this Google Docs and Google Form is automatically saved in Google Drive. This is a cloud space. And from this Google Drive, we can share our e-material either through Google Sites or through Google Classroom. So this is a holistic pictures of the Google. And at the same time, now we are using the Google Meet. This is the online video conferencing apps, that are online class. If we apply the Google Meet along with Google Classroom, Google Calendar, and Jamboard, it will be more interesting of the online classes. And finally, the most powerful part now is becoming, I think everyone knows, that is a YouTube. YouTube has become now a new teacher of the new century. As we know, the YouTube, how it is powerful. In the near future, I hope every teacher have to create the YouTube channel. And with this YouTube channel, the e-content materials can be accessible to the all students. So we, the teachers, have to face this challenge, and we should prepare ourselves for, we should update ourselves for ICT applications. So with this saying, I go to my second part, that is a Google Form. By using the Google Form, basically I will cover today the online evaluation, online examination, taking into consideration of both MCQ questions, short answer type questions, even the essay type questions. How we can conduct this online exam, even in the social distancing era, even in the post COVID-19 era also. So how we can do today, I will show one by one. So first of all, Google Form is an application add-on service. This is form is designed mainly for collection of data, but we can apply the Google Form for evaluation purpose also. Whenever we create a Google Form, a Google Sheet, that is an Excel-like sheet, is also associated with the each Google Form, and both Google Form and Google Sheet will automatically saved in a Google Drive. So what are the major steps of Google Form? Just I will share. First of all, Google Form, how we can use Google Form, then I will cover my online evaluation part. First of all, open a new Google Form, that is untitled form from Google Drive, and there is a very specific link. If we create a Google Form using our smartphone, there is no option. But if we follow this URL, that is docs.google.com/forms/create, then it will be create a automatic untitled Google Form. I will come to next slide. And after opening the new Google Form, first step, that is second step, adjust the settings and then framing the questions, second step. And third step, be very careful about these steps. Third step is very important. After framing the questions, you will share your Google Form link for getting responses. How we can share? I will show you. Next step. After getting the response, you will see the response in an Excel-like sheet, that is a Google Sheet, and we can view the response in three ways, in a summary way, in an individual way, in a question-wise analysis. And after this, getting the response, we can share our response also through website or sharing the Google Sheet. And we can stop the sharing. We can delink our website finally. So these are the six steps. If we follow one by one, we can easily use the Google Form in the various ways. Now my point is online evaluation and online examination. I'm feeling disturbance. Sorry. So before going to prepare the online evaluation using Google Form, I have mentioned the five steps. I request the participants, you may note down the five steps to conduct the online examination as well as evaluation. First step, as already I have mentioned, opening the Google Form, and after Googling for settings, the questions and setting adjustment of settings and framing questions. Step two, sharing Google Form among the students. And step three, examination, that is evaluation, no, examination by the students. And step four, after the examination of the students, teacher will evaluate the answer scripts one by one. And finally, release the score, that is publication of the result. So now I come to my practical point of view. I go to my Google Drive option. Okay. So this is a Google Drive. Now I will create a blank Google Docs, a Google Form. Look at my cursor. Here it is a plus sign. If we click on this plus sign, so Google Docs, Google Sheet, Google Docs is available. But Google Form is not directly available in this portal. So you should click on the next option, that is more. If we click on more option, the first option is Google. So click on this part. So there will be untitled form will be created. Yeah, this is a Google Forms. Now I will explain some of the features, some of the points here. First of all, whenever we open a Google Form, that is untitled form, there is a two option. Look at my cursor. There is a question and response. Two different things. First of all, we prepare, we develop, we frame the questions as we like to take the information, take the response. Now go to the settings part, that is a gear settings. If you go to the first, I request go to the settings. Since we are preparing the evaluation, since we are using this Google form for the evaluation purpose, so we make some changes in the settings. So first of all, I go to the settings of the Google form. Click. There are three parts: general parts, presentation parts, and quizzes parts. In case of general settings, I request please click on the first part, that is collect email address. This will be the compulsory question. So every student has to provide the email address, appropriate email address. The second option, limit to one response. If you like to get a one response from one student, then you will check this box. But I will request, and do not check this box. If you check this box, it will be very, to some extent, cumbersome from the end of students. Google will verify, Google will show the various pictures. After that, he can submit this. And another disadvantage of limit to one response, students must have a Gmail ID. Otherwise, he cannot participate in this evaluation. And the respondents can edit after submit and see summary charts. Since it is an evaluation, I request do not check this box. So in case of general settings, only the first part, collect email address. And now I am coming to the second part of settings, that is presentations. Here is a, there are three options: show progress bar, supple question orders, show link to submit another response. Since it is an evaluation, we should not give the another response options. Show progress bar, it is basically if you design so many questions and you like to, students will view your question order sequentially as you framed in the Google form, then you will go to this option. Show progress bar. If you evaluate the question only based on the multiple choice questions, then I will suggest not go progress bar, rather supple question order. Here, one thing I would like to say, the Google has provided the suppling the question, at the same time Google has provided the suppling the option of the questions also. Very interesting. If you set 50 questions, 50 multiple choice questions, we have already conducted the online evaluations, online question, online test examination in my college from 2017, 18 and 19. We have already experienced when we take a exam, taking the 50 questions and giving the 1 hour time, students cannot get the chance for verifying their question to other students since the questions are reshuffling or suppling. So it is very interesting part of the Google. Now here you should give a confirmation message. Students are not getting confirmed whether they have submitted successfully or not. Even the two charts, they will submit it another multiple times. But here this message, so thank you for your response or anything you can write from MKB. So my sorry. And finally come to my quiz. In case of collection of data, these two settings is enough, general and presentations. But since we are using the evaluation purpose, Google form we are using, so we go to the quiz option, very important options. First of all, by going to this option, first make this quiz button is on. Otherwise, you cannot evaluate the questions. So after on this question, there are some default settings. In this case, first option in case of release grade, immediately after each submission, if you make any practice set, I request if you make all the question in a multiple choice question, then I request you go to these options. If you make a multiple choice question as well as sort and essay type question, so it is not possible for releasing the score immediately after submission. So we will come to the second option, that is letter after manual review. And last, the respondent can see, this also option is very useful to the students. If you check this all options, after releasing the score, students will get the information which question he has missed during the exam, which are the right answer, what are the score, etc. So after setting this, you will do not forget the save option. Maximum teachers forget about the saves. So I request, please remember this point, that is, you have to save your settings. Otherwise, there will be default settings. In case of default settings, the quiz option is not there. So please remember, save. So we have cleared our saves. Now I am framing the questions. So before going to framing the question, I will just explain the nil shadow area. This is a one questions area. What are the field of this particular questions? First of all, this is an area of question. You can set a question. First, I request one question is very common. First, this is not a question, rather. Roll number, registration number, name of the students, etc. I will follow some existing settings. But before that, for save time, I will follow the existing Google form. But before that, here it is a place of the question. Here you can write your questions. Even you can upload a picture in the questions. And if you frame a question, it is a multiple choice question, there is an option. Okay, option A, option B, option C, or whatever the question, I will show you. And here the type of question, short answer, paragraph, multiple choice, checkbox, and multiple choice grid, etc. And finally, come to the lower part of these questions. Here it is a button. If we click on this button, this will be a compulsory questions. If you like to delete this question, click on this part, delete. If you make a duplicate question, click on this. And if you click on the three dots, there is a option of the answer pattern. If you make a question, suppose you make a question, say 3 plus 3, what are the answer? Say 5, say 6, say 20, etc. So here, go to the which option is the right option. Now I'm clicking on the answer key. If you do not make this quiz by going to settings, this option will not come. So if you, whenever you switch on the quiz option, this option will come automatically. So click on this answer key. What is the right option? I just click on that part. So this is a background settings. If students will opt this option, they will get the 2 marks or any marks you can set. In my Google form, there is a default settings of 2 marks in case of multiple choice questions. So done. So this question is prepared. Simple this. Whenever then you click on the add button. By clicking the add button, there will be next questions. So let's go my existing questions so that we can save them our time. Yeah. First of all, in case of title, come to here, you have just make a title. What is the title here I have used? A test examination 2020, subject cost accounting, total marks 14, duration 20 minutes. Here I have written, go to my again, a form description. All the questions are compulsory or any direction from the teachers or from the departments. So first of all, whenever we go to the settings, collect email address, the first option, that is email address, will be automatically set. And this is a default settings of the Google form or provided by the Google. Now I come to my first question, roll number and registration number. And after this, I will create a section, that is create a page by clicking on the equal sign. Whenever I click, there will be second page. How it looks, go to my preview option. This next button will come whenever we create a section. Okay. So after these two information, roll number and registration number. So there is a question. This is not a question. So marks will be 0, mind it. And in case of registration, the same. So second part, section 2 of 4, I first select the MCQ questions. I have already select 2 questions, MCQ question. EOQ is a very popular concept, you know, myself, subject, whatever. So question is not matter here. I have already developed the MCQ question and given the right option, etc. 2 questions are MCQ form, and short answer type question, section 3, that is a short answer type where students can write their answer, what is EOQ. This is, I have providing the place, short answer or paragraph. If the question is more, you will provide the paragraph. In case of literature, in case of question oriented, you will provide the space. If the students cannot write in this field, the student, you should allow to upload the file regarding the answer of the questions. So second, third part, that is essay type questions. Here I have prepared a questions, not by writing, rather I have taking a snapshot my books here, because I can upload the questions through getting the options and giving the option of add file. Now I will go to the my next question for showing how we can do this question. Any type of questions we can frame. Go to my any site. Suppose I go to a site of doorstep. This question I would like to frame. So it is not possible to draw this question. So I can use a snipping tools. This is a Windows 10 very important tool. Snipping tools, S-N-I-P-P-I-N-G. Snipping tools, if I use the snipping tools, we can crop this particular part. Go to the new, then I will come to this clearly, drag this option, and yeah, this question, I copy this. Here I copy and go to save. Okay, so I have saved it in a particular folder and the desktop save. Then I come to the second part. Again, I come to the copy this answer. It is not possible. Some teachers can do it, but I just show it how we can solve this our problem for critical question answer. Again, I go to the snapping tools. Snipping tools. Okay, I will just cover this option only. Okay, so save this, capture. Okay, so I have saved these two questions. Now I come to my Google form. Here it is a question. Go to the image, right side. In case of question, there is a option of inserting image. Click on this, then browse. Now I come to the question where I have saved. It is a desktop. Sorry, where is the question? Name of the group is I'm not sure. Where is the saving? I save this presentation. Scan. It is a snipping tool. Okay, sorry. First of all, I just upload this question. Okay, question is come. Now you can explain that the students will answer this question by writing there in their copies. So here you option give the option of file upload option. So whenever you paste this file upload option, there will be option of continue, and this will be option of file option. Okay. So in case of adding file upload option, this is a question students will give the answers by writing in their copies. So you can upload the question, even you can upload the critical MCQ question also in the answer part. I do not cover this. I will just cover how we can make a questions. Then allow only specific file types of question. In case of upload file, there is an option. I will suggest you should give the option of PDF file, image, audio, video, spreadsheet, etc. So these two options will be more appropriate in case of examination. So maximum number of files in case of one answer, this is will be one. Maximum file size 10 MB. Okay. So what is the answer of this question? Go to the answers key. Need write 4, 5, 2, 3, whatever. I have given a 4 marks. So my question is ready. Here the question is already covered. MCQ, essay type, and short answer type also. So now I am sharing my questions to my students. Now first of all, I will look the preview, how it looks like. Yes. So email address, it is compulsory. I just not cover. Next, this MCQ, just students will give this answer in this way. And since it is a required question, students cannot proceed until and unless he provide the answer of this question. So very careful about the question make required. Otherwise, students cannot submit the answers. So next question, what is MCQ? I have right here the MCQ. I have given the space of writing the answer. Here the second question is option of add file. Whenever I make add file, he will add the files. He will make a copy and copy the images. And students can do very easily. They can upload the files. I have already conducted so many examination in this way. Students are getting interest also. So these are the way. After this, he will submit. So now I come to point how we can share our Google Form question to my students. So go to the option of send. Send option. By giving the mail ID, we can share our Google Form. But it is not so easy. Otherwise, you can share your Google Form by clicking the link, copy the link, and copy your link. You share these links to your Google Classroom or Google WhatsApp group or your personal website, etc. So this link is the link for giving the responses. Now I have again one thing I would like to share. Suppose you prepare a questions one day before and you would like to start the examination just 10 a.m. tomorrow. So go to the setting. After this framing the question, go to the response site. Here is a response. There are three types of response: summary, question, and individual. Top of the individual option, there is a accepting response button. If you click this button, so if you share the link will not be functional. So link will not function until and unless you click on this button. So at the time of 10 o'clock, you just click on this button, exam will start. And 10:30, you will close this button. So in this very short, in this simple way, we can conduct our examination sitting at home. And there is the other ways I will suggest. Some of the apps is available, add-on, that is Hagma add-on is available by which we can conduct our examination automatically. There will be a time slot and time second, 1 second, tens in a descending order in the front of the page. I have also tested this add-on also. So now I am sharing. First of all, I am framing the questions. After framing the question, before framing question, if settings will be done, then question framing, then sharing. Now I will share to the participants. It is not a way. So there is no Google Classroom. If it is Google Classroom, I will share this link and you will experience as students. However, I have already get the responses from the students. Here there are 15 responses. Look at mine. If I go to one by one responses, click on this. Or directly if you click on one, so who first time submitted is the mail ID of that particular student is this. So second respondent or second student is this. So in this way, we have getting the summary of the responses. Rather, since it is a question of short answer type and easy answer type and MCQ, so MCQ part will be automatically evaluated. But in case of short answer type and essay type, we have to evaluate one by one. So go to the individual option. Teachers, please go to individual options. Now select which I have already evaluated. Only one thing I do not evaluate this answer. Here, whenever I select this student's Neha, this is a third student who have submitted this question answer. Out of the 14 marks, clear, look at my cursor. Out of 14 marks, 14 points, he got the 4 marks automatically because there is a 2 MCQ question carrying 2 marks each, and he will give probably the right answer. That's why he get the 4 marks. Here it is like a score not released. After evaluation, we can release our score one by one or as a whole. So go to the evaluation part, go to the evaluation by the teachers. These are the information. Here it is already evaluated. Green color indicates the answer is appropriate and right, and you will get 2 out of 2. In case of short answer type, what is EOQ? The answer is given by the students. By reading this answer, teachers will provide the marks. Here, one thing I would like to say, Google has very carefully developed this part. You cannot modify the answer. It is not possible. So teacher cannot modify the answer as given by the students. Rather, if I provide 1 marks out of 2, what is the reason I have not given 2 out of 2? You have given the reasons here and individual feedback. So student will get the feedback why he get less marks, even he write the appropriate answer. So I have providing here, he has rightly pointed out the answers, but there is a scope of writing more. That's why I am giving 1 marks. And if I write this, there is a feedback. Please provide more, provide other part also. You will get this my explanation. Next part, come to the second question. Here the question he has uploaded. So that is a PDF file is coming. Here I again one like to say, this particular PDF file will be automatically saved in your drive in a separate folder associated with this Google form. So all the PDF file will come to my website, to my Google Drive in a separate folder based on your Google form. So click on this PDF file. The PDF file will come. This is a simply handwriting answer of the students. Now you will check if there is any error, if there is mistake, you can provide the comments. Here he has write answer is right 202400 unit, but it will be units plural form. So you make a comment. Go to the comment options and make a comment here. Right here, comment. Yes, it will be units. The simple make a comment. Whenever you release your score, students will get this answer scripts, answer sheets with the comments of the teachers. So very interesting. Examination will be more transparent. Student will be highly satisfied. The teachers will provide the numbers and they will explain why the number is less or right answer. So more challenging rather. So we have to accept this challenge. Otherwise, I personally think with the pandemic, with the outbreak of COVID-19, education sector is now the time for major reform. As we know, there is a economic reform in the year 1991 economic reform, and after 10 years in the year of 99 and 2000, there was a reform of banking sector and insurance sector. In the year of 2015, there is a major reform of indirect tax, that is GST. Now is the reform of education sector. If the teachers, follow this, this way we can evaluate. So there will be really fruitful for the coming generation. So now, just here we put this comment, it will automatically attach in your file, and comment will be automatically saved in this document also. Here it is a everything is right. So I have provide out of 4 into 4. So just go to my question. Here I given 4 out of 4, and last question it is not answered since I have prepared last. So now I have evaluate this particular answer sheet of particular student, that is 3 number students. Now I go to the release of my score. Here look at this figure. Here I have given 2 out of 2, 2 to 4, 5. Here I get 3, rather 4. So out of the total marks he got, out of 14 he has got 9 marks, as because there is a question that is a 4 marks he has not answered. Say suppose the student will not have give the answer. So 4 out of 4, here it will get a 4 0 marks. Only 0, just for this purpose I use 0 mark. So out of 14 the students will get 9 marks. Now I will release the score. By clicking this button I can release the score of a particular students and the all students. After verification, after evaluation of all the answer scripts, I request after evaluation of all answer scripts, that is 15 answer scripts, if you click on the release button, release score, then all the mail will be checked. But in case of one evaluation, Google know the only one student has been evaluated, so only one mail ID has been checked. After this, if I release my score, send email and release. So it will be immediately go to the concerned student's email with the answer scripts, with the evaluated scripts, with the numbers. Students can see how marks, how much marks he got and why he got 9 marks out of 14, with the explanation, with the comments of the teachers. So very interesting today. Just I will cover my online evaluation, online examination. After the examination over, you will just close your button. All the answer sheet as it is given by the students will be saved in a Excel like sheet, that is a green color button. If I click on this sheets, then you will get all the details of the time slot when he will give the answers. In case of 10, he will get 4 marks, his roll number, registration number, question wise, instead of these details will also you can get. In case of MCQ question, it is very easy, but today I will cover both essay type question and short answer type question along with MCQ. So today I have completed my first part. Hello Devabrata, I am not actually visualizing the students, my participants. That's why I am not sure whether the participants will get my response or get my lectures properly or not. Hello Devabrata. Hello Devabrata. Anyone in this platform, Devabrata or anyone? I am not sure whether the participants, I do not know. Very difficult. At least 2 or 3 persons, if it is associated with my platform, it will be helpful to me. Okay, it should be coming.
There are 174 participants are there now. They are okay. Viewing your lecture. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes. Don't worry. You can go through.
Okay.
Question and answer will be there at the end of your lecture.
If anyone is asking any question after this part, this will be helpful. I will come to my next part. That is, it is a hands-on training rather. Anyone may ask question, you will share it. Otherwise, I will go to my second part. This platform.
If there is any question, I will communicate with you. Okay.
Okay. So you will call me. I do not understand whether the participants will get interest or not. I am not sure. So this is a very difficult task to me to carry on this lecture without getting any feedback from any side. Really tough. So if I go through the YouTube site, is it possible to know the feedback, at least whether they will understand or not? Okay, so let's go my second part, that is application part. I will not cover now after the very important part, that is third part. Second part, application part I will cover rather I will go to my third part. If time permits, if audience, if participants is interested, then I will cover the second part, application of Google, very interesting part. How we can use the Google Apps in a different ways, in a practical purpose. I am very much interested. But before that, I will share my opinion regarding the online class. Okay. So any question? No questions. I do not know whether question is coming or not. Am I audible? Clearly audible.
Dr. Grewal, do you have any collected question on that particular topic?
Yeah.
Hello, Dr. Grewal, are you ready to have any questions?
Okay, now I come to my second part, or the third part of my lecture. Okay.
There may have some questions at the end of your lecture, I think.
Okay, no problem. So second part, the third part of my lecture, just I will share my opinions and views regarding basically online classes. And I would like to share my opinion regarding the flipped class. The concept of flipped class may define the future of higher education in India. What about the flipped class? I will just take 3 or 4 minutes just to explain what about the flipped class. And after that, I will recommend my suggestions regarding the online class and etc. As we know, the education is taking a new shape, undoubtedly, with the help of technology. Now the traditional case is now converting to virtual class, to smart class, now in the smartphone, that is an online class, staying at home, at anywhere, at any time basis. This is a very important part of the reform of the education. We the teachers should accept it. I first of all raise my voice in favor of my online class, because I have given some reasons. I am totally conducting various online classes in my colleges. Before going to my discussion regarding online classes, first of all, I would like to share some real data in my colleges. Here in my college. Hello.
Are you getting the screen having a question? No.
Okay, this slide is visible?
Yes.
Regarding online class during lockdown? Is it visible? Pie chart? Hello?
You just share your screen.
I have already shared the screen, and now I am going to the second tab of my... Again, I will share my screen.
Yes, okay. You have to share. You just out of your screen now. Kindly share again.
Okay. Which option I should opt for? Screening share in the easiest with two monitors?
No. Share your screen. You can go through. Click on the share your screen and share okay. screen. You click on share screen.
Okay. Is it visible? Is it visible?
Yes.
Okay. So now, just before going to discuss what about the online class, my opinion regarding online class, regarding the concept of flipped class, just I would look to share some real data. In my colleges during lockdown, there are 1055 online classes has been conducted by the teachers. Out of this, more than 1000 online classes. From this picture, it is clear the most popular apps is now Zoom app. By using Zoom apps, 66% classes has been conducted using Zoom apps and followed by Google Meet and Skype. So this is my first sharing regarding the online class. Now I am getting the response from the students who are participating in the online class. I once again mention online class means not the sharing material through Google Classroom or WhatsApp group. I would like to point out the online class means classes through video conferencing apps. Particular on that part, I am focusing in my lecture. So first area, if you look, the teachers have started a online classes. Please read these online teaching learning initiation of the college during lockdown period if you have participated in this initiation. So there are 860 responses coming from the students. And out of 860 responses, 34% in favor of excellent and 50% in favor of good. And only the 5.9% are not satisfied with this initiation. Though they have participated in the online classes. So this is very important. Those who have participated, they will give the answers only. Mind it. All the students at this moment not participating. As we know, there is a problem of internet. Regarding internet problem, I will again share my opinion. Next question, would you recommend your friends to participate in this online learning system? 93% says yes. Next question, come to my question, what is the opinion regarding online sharing of e-material, etc.? Very important sharing I would like to share with you. Where do you stay now? Out of 45 students, look at 67%, near about 68% students are sitting from village. Village, you cannot imagine, that are the really remote village. One thing once more, teachers are sharing with me, the students who are calm in the regular class, they are also calm in the online class. Those who are not coming in the regular class, they are not. So only the reasons, the poor, and the students who have not smartphone, they are not accessing this platform. That is not. As a teacher, I have go through all the feedbacks, all the details. I am connecting with the students as well as teachers. There is a tremendous opportunity of online class. Students are getting interest finally. I do not know what will be the future of our traditional class system, but I have some definite opinion and recommendation regarding this. But I will, again, someone has already shared in the teacher, in the Facebook, in the various social media, we the teachers should not divide our poor and village students digitally. I strongly oppose this proposition. If we raise this voice against this online platform, against this online class, again we will, the students of the interior village, the meritorious students, will be deprived in future. Just like a introduction of computer in the 30 and 40 years back, when someone opposed the computer, do not introduce, they are not composing the computer. They have given the information, if computer will be introduced, there will be a jobless. But today, without computer, the live human life is next to impossible. So if we do not follow, if we do not update ourselves regarding online class, even offline class, education reform, ICT use, so students will be, I hope there will be a major challenge both in case of students and teachers. So I request, do not go to the raise voice only because of students are not getting internet facility. If there is a demand of the internet facilities, I hope it will be covered. Internet service provider is very much ready regarding the development of online class platform. You have already known so many platforms is developing day by day, not only Zoom, Google Meet and Skype. So I request, please accept it, and it will be helpful both of us. I will challenge our professions using both offline and online. So let us come to my presentations. Again, that is a presentation of flipped class. Okay, so education is now changing. The shape of education is changing with the help of technology. The existing teaching practice, from my point of view, purely based on my experience, the traditional system based on the three parts, that is teaching methods. First one is delivery of content, second part is knowledge imparting, and third part is evaluation. Everyone knows. But in the traditional system, we the teacher have to spend 70 to 80% of our class for delivery of content deliverations. We have to force to spend very little bit time, that is 15 to 20% for knowledge imparting, and finally only 10 minutes for evaluation purpose. Basically, this is a semester end examination or yearly end examination, and after the examination there will be a reassessment and live long process, but the evaluation we will take only one or two. With these methods and the traditional system, very much note based and stereotype question based, and because of this, the first part, delivery of content, is very important, that is information sharing. But Google has provided all the informations, so we the teacher should not devote more time for the second part, which is very important part of the teaching, that is knowledge imparting part. We have to spend only 15 to 20 minutes. Content sharing will make perhaps job more difficult, and have to spend more time in classroom for content sharing. We have to spend, so let's go, today we will take a new class. Basically, in the first class, we will sharing the content. So we can share the content before the class by using video material, by using audio material, by using PPT, etc. So before the class, if we cover this part, delivery of content, so we can devote more time in the second part, that is knowledge part. Again, teachers cannot devote more time for analysis or doubt clearing purpose. But remember, teaching is much more than good content delivery. So this is our existing system. With this existing teacher, how the concept of flipped class may change our teaching practice. Now, second slide. So concept of education in 21st century, basically blended learning, you have already known with this term. Basically, I got this term in the year of 2016, probably, when I go get a ICT workshop in the Bombay IIT, 6 months duration. After that, blended learning is nothing but the combination of education, of combination of both online and offline, nothing more. I will focus my blended learning. The part of blended learning is a flipped class. What about flipped class? So flipped classroom is a type of blended learning. So flipped class is a combination of both online and offline mode, where students are introduced to content at home and practice working through it at institution in face-to-face mode. But in our traditional system, we are basically provide the content in our class. We are rather assign the homework in their home. So this is a flip, that is a reverse process. In case of flipped class, students will be introduced the content at home before the class. And during the class, we will more focus on the imparting of knowledge part in the face-to-face mode. So there is another difference as given by the Flipped Learning Network 2005. This is a pedagogical approach in which direct instruction moves from the group of learning space to the individual learning space. And the resulting group space is transformed into a dynamic, interactive learning environment. Whether the educator guides students as they apply concepts and engage creatively in the subject matter. This is a very important definition rather about what classroom. So concept of flipped classroom basically introduced by two chemistry teachers, Jonathan Bergman and Aaron Sams. They are chemistry teachers in the year of 2012. In their books, Flip Your Classroom, Reach Every Student in Every Class in Every Day. So I am just sharing my opinion regarding the introduction of flipped class in the social distancing era or the era coming ahead, that is post COVID-19 period. So what about the concept of flipped class? Rather, I will one again explain. So every class has a three phases. One is before class, during class, after class. So before class, we the teacher should share our material. So content sharing, e-content sharing, just for the remembering and understanding the content. Students will try to visualize, try to understand the content, that is information. So first part is information sharing, e-content. Here I once again suggest, please here you should share the video material. It will be more attractive in your own language, in your own style of teaching, in a Bengali or Hindi, English, whatever the combination. Students will touch, teachers will take the classes. He will view you through the YouTube link. So many video materials is available in the YouTube, but all the YouTube video material is not so appropriate for the students, because YouTube video should be developed basically curriculum based, important question based, important topic based, and then the question they are facing in the examination hall. So again, here in this part, I request, I suggest, please the teacher please develop the video material, and that will be helpful to share in the next years also. You can save more time at the time of developing video material. You will be more serious regarding the development of e-material, as this material will be shared by the students, by the public. So you will be judged whether you are appropriate teacher or not, whether your content is more resourceful or not, etc. So teacher will be judged in case of online class. At this time, my son is experiencing so many online classes. I have also experiencing the tutor, with the tutor, what are the tutor are doing in the class, whether they are well prepared, whether they are engaged in the teaching process, whether they are providing the classroom material, etc. So we can judge my son in my class. This is an opportunity of the parents. So parents will judge whether teacher will responsible, whether accountable, whether resourceful, etc. We can judge. So this is a time of judging the teaching practice. So we have to face this challenge. Very important part of this online class, and that is transparent class. I request, please don't take it otherwise. I am very much positive in this sense. That's why I am telling this. So days are coming not very easy. We only the teachers are not in the field of actual field of COVID-19 or etc. So we do not know whether college will reopen, whether it is August, September, October. We do not know. So I request, please go to online class. This will justify our service. That's why I am telling you. So during classes, the teacher will basically doubt clearing part, application, analyzing, practicing, all this. So teacher will give more focus during classes on the knowledge imparting part, rather doubt clearing part. And after that, after the class, you will take an evaluation. So that is very easy if you follow the Google form. So each and every class, there will be three parts. And this is the reverse of more common practice of introducing new content in school and college, then assigning homework and projects to completed by the students independently at home. This is a reverse. They will practice in face-to-face class, but we will provide the information in your class, and we will assign the work to be completed by the students independently at home. This is not. So flipped means the switch off, turn on, turn off as students wish. These are nothing more. I will come to very important side. Why flipped class? Why I am recommending it? Why I am in favor of the concept of flipped class? There are so many advantages. The flipping speaks the language of today's students. Students are very much, you do not know, you may know also, the students are very much friendly with the smartphone, but they are not using the smartphone as an important tools of teaching or learning. If we using online class, if we using Google Classroom, student will be more engaged with their smartphone. We cannot say the students should not use smartphone. Some of the guardians, some of the teachers are not in favor of using the smartphone, but it is not possible today. So if we force the students, if students get the smartphone as a important tools for using for important tools for his study, for his learning, so it will be helpful for flipped class also. So flipping helps busy students. Okay, very important. Flipping helps students of all abilities to excel, because flipping allows students to pause and review their teacher. So subject content material, he can view anytime, anywhere, as his wish. He can pause and review the teacher. Very important part of the flipping class, a very important part of sharing content with the class. And flipping increases the student-teacher interaction, as the teacher will be engaged in 24/7 hours through Google Classroom or anything else. So there will be a very much, students will be more engaged. Student will get a scope of education in his smartphone. So finally, other advantages. Flipping allows teachers to know their students better. We can categorize the students in the advanced and learning slow learners through the Google Classroom. We can share our questions to the advanced students or slow learners. So there is a plenty of opportunity of Google Classroom where we can share our content. We can evaluate the students in a different ways. And finally, flipping changes the way we talk to parents. Flipping educate parents also. So flipping is a great technique for absent teachers and absent students also. If anyone absent, he will, no problem, he will get the content, etc., etc. So this is the very important parts of advantages of flipped class. So what are the advantages of online education, which I personally perceive at this moment? There are so many advantages, I am not mentioning this. Only four advantages which I think this will be the more important in the days coming. The advantages and opportunity of the online course now failed by the masses. All the private school colleges are rigorously go through the online platform. With this platform, the students as well as parents are getting the advantage and opportunity of online class. The most reliable advantage of online mode offers it is super flexibility on timing and delivery. Since in most of the cases in our colleges, students are basically, majority students are coming for getting, mainly don't mind getting certificates. Actually, nowadays, regarding the general degree courses, the job opportunity is not enough. So with this background, students are basically like to opt for online distance course. If they get the certificate like a regular university, if sitting from Malda, if he get the certificate from JNU University by opting online distance course, what will be the future of the general degree college like me, like us? So please, teachers, think about this. Students may opt for online degree courses. Days are coming. So if students are not coming in our colleges, so what will be? So we should prepare. We should accept all the challenges of ICT online classes. If we update ourselves, we can easily challenge all this. We can convert all these challenges into the opportunities. I personally think that. Transfer of knowledge through online class is possible. The bottom line of the success of online course is the engagement of students. Very important point. Knowledge component is more natural to deliver in online mode also. Online education is a low-cost alternative, very vital. So government may opt for cost, low-cost option. So that's why it will be more popular. Popular or not popular, may opt for the online platform. That is the challenge. That is the threats. So that's why we are, if we the teachers, accept all the challenges, convert the challenges into the opportunity, so we can stand. With the introduction of privatization of bank, government banks face the challenge That's why government banks is still now playing the pioneer role in the banking sector of India. Only six or seven private banks are dominant in the market. Otherwise, all are the public sector banks. Only because they will face the challenge at the time of banking sector reform. So, in case of education sector reform, if we follow this challenge, if we update ourselves, we can easily challenge. We can easily accept our challenge. We can easily convert our challenge into opportunities. So, that is my message. It will take teachers more accountable and more engagement of students and teachers. Online class is possible to make teachers more accountable. So, recommending during and post social distancing area, I have recommended 4 or 5 recommendations from my experience. Teachers are to be coped with technological aspect for developing and sharing e-content material in the form of audio, video, PPT, PDF, etc. Teachers should develop. Very easy, no problem. Teachers should share his or her own video. I recommend, please share video materials. Students are getting bored regarding the share of material of PDF. In major cases, teachers are downloading some PDF files and they are sharing this PDF file through the WhatsApp group. That PDF file is not so appropriate in maximum cases. So I request, please develop your own material. Even in the Bengali language, students will get more interested. Today we will give answer in the Bengali language. We, the teacher, are sharing so many PDF file in the English language. So there is a question. So teacher should share his own video material in own language, which are to be developed considering the background of his or students, considering a particular class, particular topic, particular subtopic at its own style of teaching. The second part, once again, I request, please develop your material, that is video material, just considering your student, considering the strength and weakness and the background of your students. That material is not available in the YouTube platform. That's why I am recommending. If you develop your material for your students, for your classroom students, it will be helpful to the students. So material developed for the, say, Jawaharlal Nehru University may not be fit for the students of Golwang University. That's why I am saying this. Teachers are to be coped with online class through standard apps or software like Zoom, Google Meet, TeamLink, Skype, etc. And many more are coming in days. Jio has also developing Jio Meet. So there will be plenty of video conferencing apps and that will be free. I think so. And syllabus, my third recommendation, very important. These are coming in this way. I suggest this. Syllabus to be framed to cover 60% in offline, 40% in online, or 70-30 or whatever. So syllabus to be framed in that way. So we, the teacher, should cover syllabus through online mode, through offline mode also. Online evaluation and automatic gradations are to be introduced immediately from the university level. No semester and examination, rather continuous evaluation through the year, through semester. Question framing is an important part of these evaluations. So student, teachers should frame the question so that student cannot get the answer from the Google, searching the Google platform. So there is a question. Another question, how we can frame our questions. So this is a very important part. So online evaluation, we have to go. At this moment, university, government do not decide whether they will proceed for online, offline, or anything else. Students are getting confused for the information. Day by day, they are getting the information whether examination will do or not. So there is the options of someone recently, the government of West Bengal Higher Education Department has announced the 50% will come from the previous examination, 50% from assignment, internal evaluation, etc. So in this part, I recommend if we go to the online part that I have covered in my previous lecture, it will make assignment. The students will give the answer, open book examination, assignment. Since time will be constant, So there will be a judgment to some extent, I think so. And if the offer will be given to the students, if you go to the offline or online, this is up to you. If you give the online, you can appear the examination in your home with your books. Or if you do not have any internet access, or if you do not like to provide answers through online mode, you will come to the college and use the offline mode. If this is the two options are given, my personal experience is majority students go for the online options. They will share smartphone also from their neighbors or etc. I experienced that. In my opinion, in my colleges, there are we get the in study 97% of the students have the internet access through smartphone. In our real remote village, Malda is a urban area, but the students are coming from the village. So in our colleges, 96 to 97% students have the internet access mainly from the smartphone. But they are not using the smartphone for education purpose. They are using for some other purpose. We, the teachers, should be responsible for that. And first, final recommendation. Teaching is much more than good content delivery. Mind it. So if you develop your study material and video material, it will helpful to give more time on the knowledge imparting part. And you can avoid the repetitive work if you develop the video material. That material, you can, after modification, you can share with your students. And examination, evaluation, gradation become easy, less time consuming, transparent, if we rely on online platform. So I think the concept of flipped classroom may be a 21st century classroom. So with this saying, I conclude my lecture. If you take interested, then I will cover second part, that is application of Google Apps in the teaching learning as well as administrative practice, and it will take 15 to 20 minutes. So if you take if you interested, then I proceed for the second part, that is application of Google Apps. Thank you.
Dr. Boydo, please open your chat box, private chat box.
Okay.
There are some questions, and Dr. Grayal is there.
Yeah.
Dr. Grayal is there. You just see there are some questions on your first lecture.
I am typing questions just in case of audio. If anyone speaks this question, it will be helpful to me.
The first question is, how many students can join Google Classroom at a time?
At this moment, Google has given 100 students, but we have tried more than 100 students is also included. In my class, there are 180 students. So in a free version, if we go to the G Suite version, the limit, there will be no limit. If you search in the Google platform, how many students can be accommodated, there is a 500. Purchase the G Suite version of Google Classroom, yes, then it will be 500. Probably in the free version, I do not know. From my experience, it will be 200.
And there is another question. What are the infrastructure requirements for Google Classroom?
No infrastructure, only the internet or Google Classroom apps and browser. No more. No software, no everything.
And another question is there from the audience. How to use Google Classroom in Bengali?
Oh, no problem. Actually, Google Form, Google, everything you can write. Again, I just 1 minute I will take. Just please give me 1 minute.
Definitely, please share your screen.
Now again, I am to share the screen just to show you can type English, Hindi, English, anything language. So no problem, even by voice typing. This page is okay. Is it visible? Hello? This slide is visible. Hello?
Yes, sir. Visible. You can go through.
Yeah. Visible?
Yes, it is visible.
Okay. Just take another. First, now I am typing this through my voice in my mobile. I am opening the same Google slide, and just I am uttering the sound, and it will be automatically typed in the slide. I would like to convey my sincere thanks to the organizers for giving me this opportunity. Really, it is very interesting, error free, even spelling is good. In case of a pop and down, there will be some problems. I also convey my sincere thanks to Dr. S.K. Das, Vice Principal of Bhairab Ganguly College. Okay, so in this way we can type. Okay, so next I will go to the Bengali version again in this slide. আপনারা সবাই ভালো থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন, ভয় পাবেন না, আতঙ্কিত হবেন না। সময়টা কিন্তু খুব কঠিন, রুখে দাঁড়াতে হবে আমাদের। সোশ্যাল ডিস্টেন্সিং নয়, রাদার ইট উইল বি ফিজিক্যাল ডিস্টেন্সিং। I oppose the term social distancing. Okay, so in this way we can type the Bengali, English, even Hindi, Arabic, and more than 25 languages. Any other questions?
Another question is there. That is how to write mathematical expression in Google form.
Okay. There is an option of tools, Google GMAT. I know this question, someone is asking this several times. Particularly, I am not associated with the mathematics. There is an application in my colleges, some teachers are using mathematical applications. GMAT option, there is other add-on services. Otherwise, you will copy the mathematical expression and paste it in the question. It is very easy story. Those who are using the platform Python, etc., they will do easily.
Next question is from Atonu Mitro. He is asking that in my subject, chemistry, still 80% or more jobs needs the laboratory skill. So how you can overcome this problem in this situation?
Yeah, this is a very challenging question, rather. I know whenever I share in my college group, please take the online classes. Some of the teachers are saying, is there any order from the government? Is there any, today is my off day, today is my free day. I have learned, I have heard this feedback from my learned teachers. So this is another option given from the student science teachers. They know this is not possible for the practical class. But I suggest if teacher is take the practical classes, go to the classes, taking the two students, go to the college. There is no and not a lockdown is not so serious. So concerned teachers, Atanu Babu, please go to your college and call your two or three students. One day you cover the practical, in the second day you will call another students. You can do this. Otherwise, this is not possible, but virtual lab is coming. A day is coming. In advanced country, the lab is already prepared, virtual lab. So this will be again challenge for the practical classes.
Okay, thank you sir, very much, sir, for your answer. There is another question from Artho Sarathi Aich. Sir, how it is possible to edit a recorded video lecture with both video, text, and animation learning questions? Is there any facility available with YouTube add-on facility?
Actually, there is a different software for editing videos, etc. If you interest, go to the video lecture software, video editing apps also available. If you practice it, you can do this. So I one thing here, in case of development of e-material, that is video material, my suggestion is, if you install the Zoom apps in your computer, so by opening your Zooms, by starting a class, no students will be present, just you will go to the record options. In the background, you will open your PowerPoint presentations and you will deliver your lectures with a pause and stop option. After that, you will share your material to your students. So, Zoom apps, using Zoom apps, you can record your video material. It is more easier. I have recorded so many videos using the platform of Zoom. And there are some other that is OBS Studio and other video editing options is available.
Another question is there.
Here one thing I would like to say, since video material contains a huge bytes, more than 500 MB, etc. That's why I am requesting video material should confine within 30 minutes duration, and it should be uploaded through the YouTube. YouTube platform has no limit of GB or byte. So I request you upload your video in your YouTube. You do not upload in the Google Drive, because Google Drive is a space of 15 GB. So YouTube, after uploading the YouTube, you will share a YouTube link to your students. Rather, I am recommending here, I am very much using nowadays, you should create a YouTube channel. The days are coming, every teacher should have a YouTube channel. With this channel, if something is uploaded in your channel, students will automatically get the feedback notification. So my teacher has uploaded a particular new document or etc. Thank you. Next question.
Next question is there. From Partho Sarathi Aich, he is asking that does flip learning involve both recorded classes and live sessions? During the live sessions, how it is possible to pause and rewind the lecture sessions if a student fails to catch up a live class?
Actually, pause or ruin is possible. This is in case of content, e-content material, which I have, which teachers shared before the classes. In that part, actually, the content sharing, we have covered 70% of our time, so we can save our time. So rewind and pause is possible in case of e-content material, that is video material.
Yeah.
In case of face-to-face, it is just like a normal class.
Right.
My point is, if we share our e-content material before the class through the video lecture, so in my class, we can giving more time for knowledge imparting part. Doubt clear.
Thank you very much for your good answer. And another audience who is viewing this lecture, Ms. Moumita De, she is asking that many of our students belong to the BPL category.
Whatever.
So many of our students belong to BPL category. They do not have any smartphone or PC.
Yeah.
how could we communicate with them or to reach them?
I know this is a question. Still, I am doing, I requesting you please use Google Classroom. If students have created a Google Gmail account, he can access in any time. So I request the concerned teacher, please create the Gmail account of the particular students and you include the, him or her in your Google Classroom. So if they do not have any, mail ID is compulsory. In case of admission, you know the mail ID is compulsory. So students who have does not have a smartphone or laptop or etc., he can access, even go to the cyber cafe or etc.
Okay, thank you very much, Dr. Boydo, for your nice presentation. Now I would hand over to Dr. Sanjit Kumar Das to conclude the session and for his talk.
Thank you, Dr. Boydo, for your presentation. Thank you very much. And I hope that all the participants have enjoyed and enriched by your presentation, and there are so many problems have been solved, and they are preparing themselves with your guidance and with your suggestions. And thank you very much, sir. And I also thank Dr. Abul Salam for being with us and handling the webinar in a perfect fashion. And sir, your job is not over. You have to stay with us for a long time today. Stay safe, and thank you all of you. And we will resume the session at 2:45. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you to all of you.